I thought Dartmouth did a good job and gave us a good battle. We were hoping we'd play a little better and maybe get an easy victory tonight, but nothing seems to come easy. I thought we did a great job in the second half with our press, and our defense was very good, I thought, for most of the game, except on two players, Trotter and especially Barnett. I think Hodge had a great scout report on. We wanted to make him a left-handed driver and really not give him any open threes, and we were kind of playing on our heels, and he was getting, I don't want to say open looks, but pretty good shots for him. We just didn't adjust, and he lit us up almost single-handedly, kept them in the game along with Trotter. But I think Mike Trimboli had a great game. Obviously, Garvey played real well. Marcus was very good, especially offensively, but he's got to learn and make better decisions on the defensive end of the court. And he continues to get reach-in fouls and get into foul trouble. We're a much better team with him on the court. So we got to learn from these experiences as a junior now. And he's got to hold back. There's no reason to get a steal. Just play solid defense. So it's hard to press and things when he's on the bench. But I was happy to get a win. And I would have liked to pull away a little easier. But we just give them credit. They really hung in there and battled. I give Barnett a lot of credit. We didn't have an answer for him, and he lit us up.
Pleased to get those wins that you didn't get last year, get some of them in this year?
Oh, yeah, definitely. We won three in a row, and I think our four wins are against all teams that beat us last year. And Dartmouth we really wanted to get because we felt that the game up there we had won, and it was all kind of a crazy call away from the ball. And so it's something that we were very disappointed it happened, and so we definitely wanted to get them, especially at home. We wanted to go undefeated at home this year, and we lost that Mason game, a tough game, but hopefully we can hold our home court serve here and try to win the rest of our home games, and that should put us in pretty good positions, especially with the league games.
You guys have been playing pretty well. How do you feel heading into number three, Pittsburgh?
Well, we got to play a lot better. We got to play like we did against Maryland, and I think we really have to cut back on these turnovers or really silly. Like tonight, we just don't keep our composure. We're up 16 points and we're throwing these crazy alley-oops and simple inbounds play. We're throwing the ball away. And those are things you can't do if you want to compete with Pittsburgh, number three team in the country, whatever they are. But I think our guys will play loose now, and hopefully we'll hit some shots. We've definitely got to get more out of Maurice Joseph. Garvey's going to have to start. So we got to get some shots. Guys got to make some shots, that are supposed to be shooters. But I see a lot of good things, and hopefully Joey can bounce back. He got hurt a little bit tonight, and we'll be fine. But it was good to see Mike Trimboli break out. I think he's been doing a great job with his assists, and his defense is much improved this year. But tonight, I thought he played at both ends of the court. He hit the shots he normally hits, so it was nice to have two guys in the 20s, and having Garvey at 19 really really helped. And Nick's been playing great all year. Tonight wasn't one of his better games, but we were able to overcome that.
Mike, at halftime, you had 9 turnovers, but you shot 65%. Well, I also thought, and I could be wrong, that your defense was inconsistent in the first half. You picked up the intensity defensively in the second half. Did you buy that?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, they shot a good percentage from the game. I mean, they shot 59%, but they didn't, we made them work. I thought we really wore them out with our press, and we created, I don't think they had many turnovers at halftime. They don't have
4.
So they had 9 in the second half, and thought our press really worked. But we just had more energy and enthusiasm in the second half. And like I said, we got that thing up to 16 and seemed with a lot of time left, and then we would just make a silly foul or, a silly turnover, which would kind of keep them in the game a little bit. But I really was happy with the energy because, we definitely had a win with our defense tonight. Colin was struggling from the field, and like I said, Nick didn't have his best game. So our defense really won the game. And Evan really did not play well in the first half. He had no energy, just lackadaisical. I give him credit. I thought he really helped when he came in the game, and that was when we picked it up defensively and gave us a bigger body out there.
Do you like the balanced scoring you're getting, Mike? Obviously, so you just mentioned that Colin was a little bit off, but you got some points from Garvey. Seems like you're getting offense from a variety of sources this season.
Oh, definitely. We got a lot of guys that can score, and honestly, like Garvey, I know he can score, but we really need his defense more than anything. I tried to tell him the other night, we won tonight with defense, and he's got to understand that the defense is what's going to win for us when we're not, playing particularly well, offensively. And, we made shots, but I didn't think we were clicking, and the turnovers are what kills you, The turnovers give you less possessions, but I think that scoring's nice. But I really look at the other end of the court a lot more, and when Evan picked up his defense, and you know, Marcus and Mike were playing really well in defense. I thought Marcus could shut that kid down. It's just, you know, sometimes he goes for steals and just, you know, I'm having trouble getting our team to understand that, you know, time and score situations, you really just want to play solid and, you know, not stop the clock. And you got to stay out of foul trouble. You got to stay out of foul trouble for us to be a really good team.
You were 20, your top three scorers were 26 for 35 from the floor. How often have you seen something like that from a group of three starters?
Well, that's pretty good. I knew Marcus would play great tonight offensively because, Loyola did a good job. They got physical with him and double teamed him. He missed shots he usually makes, and he's usually a great passer out of the double team. So I knew he was going to have a big game. And I was surprised they didn't double him, it seemed like, in the second half. So we were like, just score. I mean, he's got the little Hakeem Olajuwon dream shake on the baseline. And, some of his other moves, and, one guy I don't think can really guard him, especially at our level. So I thought he did a good job not waiting for a double team and just, taking his man to the, to the basket. And I thought Garvey, the best thing about him, his shot selection was excellent tonight. When he's open, he's got the green light, and he took good shots tonight. And like I said, Mike really was Mike Trimboli tonight offensively. Like, he's done a great job all year at the other things, which we've been stressing, but he hit those shots tonight we've all kind of come to expect. So we got a lot of firepower this year, and I think when we play, when we play good defense, we're going to be tough to beat. So, and I thought our crowd got in the game when the guy screened Joey, and he got hit in the eye. I thought they really got into it, and our team feeds off the energy of the crowd. So it was nice. And I'm not going to sit here, hey, we won by 17 points, and we're 2 points from being 5-0. So I'm really happy. I'm really happy with our team. I'm happy for Mike. I just, I'm a perfectionist, and I want to get better. And I want number 23 to stop reaching in when he has three fouls and stop trying to take charges. Because our game plan, I told Marcus if the game was close, we would put him on number one, and it almost kind of worked out well, but then he got a little bit of foul trouble. We just didn't want to waste Marcus's energy in the first half guarding him. Mojo did a good job early, and then the kid kind of caught on fire.
Coach,